Coming up on today's show, we're going to be breaking down the latest news and rumors surrounding 49ers quarterback Trey Lance. Could he be on the move? The 49ers are reportedly fielding calls for the former first-round pick. He was the third overall pick in the 2021 draft. Less than 2 years later, they might be shopping him. Ian Rapoport tweeted this out this morning. Sources: the 49ers have received inquiries from several teams looking into a potential trade for former number three pick quarterback Trey Lance. The conversations have been the result of San Francisco fielding the calls, not making them, with teams aware that Brock Purdy is likely the future starter. Now, before we get into more about this, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Help Chat Sports get to 331,000 subscribers. Need less than 400 more. Be sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you're watching this on Texans Today, subscribe to Texans Today as well for more Houston Texans news and rumors. So Trey Lance, this is not a huge shock that we're hearing that he could be on the move. It might have been a surprise a few weeks ago when Brock Purdy's health was a little bit more uncertain, but it's looking like Purdy's going to be ready early on in the season, if not before the season is set to begin, of course, recovering from that UCL injury that he suffered in the NFC Championship game. They also have Sam Darnold on this team as a backup quarterback. So apparently a lot of teams around the league believe that, hey, San Francisco, they're going to be going with Brock Purdy. Trey Lance, is he available? A lot of teams in need of quarterbacks that maybe are kind of unsure about some guys in the NFL draft that might be inquiring about Trey Lance. Ian Rapoport followed up that first tweet with this one. While no trade is imminent and the 49ers would almost certainly want to make sure Brock Purdy's rehab continues to go as smoothly as it's been going, the interest from other teams in Lance has been there. Taking a look at the career stats. And the thing with Trey Lance is, yeah, the potential's there, but he's certainly unproven. Just four career starts, 54.9% completion percentage, just under 800 passing yards, so roughly 200 passing yards per start, five touchdowns, three picks, 235 rushing yards, one rushing touchdown for the dual-threat quarterback. Here's what the 49ers QB room looks like right now. So Brock Purdy, in less than a year, went from QB3 to QB1. They signed Sam Darnold this offseason. I think that if they shot Trey Lance, they'd certainly feel comfortable with Darnold, who looked pretty good in Carolina last year. They would feel comfortable with him being QB2. Jimmy Garoppolo has obviously departed for Las Vegas. So the 49ers quarterback room certainly interesting right now. Will Trey Lance get traded? What do you think? Go down in the comment section and predict it. Type Y for yes or type N for no down in the comment section. Again, the 49ers are apparently taking calls on the former first-round quarterback. And when I heard that earlier today from Ian Rapoport, there were two teams that immediately came to my mind. And the main reason being is their connection with Trey Lance. And I'll get to that in a second. But the two teams I thought of were the Houston Texans and the Tennessee Titans. And I believe the Houston Texans might be the front runners here to land Trey Lance in a possible trade, because there's recently been a lot of noise that the Texans won't take a quarterback at number two overall, which I think is pretty crazy, but that's been the speculation, that's been the rumor. GM Nick Caserio admitted the other day that his team has fielded calls about trading back from number two overall. So is trading for Trey Lance a possibility if the Texans are not sold on any quarterback outside of Bryce Young? Because apparently Bryce Young's really the only quarterback they're excited about. They're not sold on C.J. Stroud. They're not sold on Will Levis. They're not sold on Anthony Richardson. And they don't want to reach on a guy like maybe Hendon Hooker at number two overall. So it might make some sense here for the Texans to inquire about Trey Lance. And I fully expect them to reach out if they haven't already, because Ian Rapoport's saying that multiple teams have contacted the San Francisco 49ers. And another reason I think the Texans might make some sense here for Trey Lance is the connections with Houston. You have the new head coach, DeMeco Ryans. He came from San Francisco. He was the defensive coordinator the last 2 years in San Francisco. Not to mention the guy that D'Amico hired as his offensive coordinator, Bobby Slowick. He was the passing game coordinator in San Francisco last year, working directly with Trey Lance. So you have that San Francisco connection with the Houston Texans. And even before this tweet, this report from Ian Rapoport, the last couple of weeks, we've been thinking, man, if Trey Lance were to get moved, could the Texans inquire? I fully expect the Texans to be serious contenders here for quarterback Trey Lance if he gets moved. Got the draft to look forward to next week. Could a Trey Lance trade happen before the draft? Certainly possible. Be sure to go get ready for the draft by picking up your favorite team's NFL draft cap, official NFL draft cap, I might add, at chatsports.com/NFL draft hats. All of the draft hats are there, and I really like the color combinations with the draft hats this year. You got some of those. You got a couple flat bills. I know Harrison Graham has a similar-looking Chicago Bears hat. Atlanta Falcons, another team we have on there. So go get ready for the draft by picking up the hat that your new favorite player is going to be wearing, right? These are the guys that will be repping your team once they get drafted by your team. Chatsports.com/NFL draft hats. That link is in the comments and the description of today's video. We just mentioned the Trey Lance trade rumors. Another player that has been in a lot of rumors as of late is Vikings running back Dalvin Cook. Could he get traded? He's certainly been the subject of trade rumors this offseason. However, ESPN's Jeremy Fowler reported earlier this week that the Vikings running back could get cut. And if that's the case, there's certainly going to be a lot of teams interested in his services because he has been one of the more consistent running backs in the NFL over the last couple of seasons. Four straight 1,000-yard seasons, multiple Pro Bowl appearances. And you look at the numbers have been really good. And he's put up those numbers when he hasn't been 100% the last year or two. His shoulders kind of been banged up. His agent admitted that he was kind of avoiding contact to his injured shoulder. So he was not present at voluntary workouts in Minnesota earlier this week. He's in Florida right now, continuing to rehab his shoulder. He's expected to be 100% by the start of the season. Maybe he's just going to stay in Florida, not go back to Minnesota, because the Miami Dolphins here are the big favorites for his next team. There's a, I should say, plus 300 odds that he's going to stay in Minnesota, plus 250 odds that he goes to Miami. So according to Vegas here, there's actually a better chance of him going to Miami than staying in Minnesota. Some other teams to watch out for here: the Philadelphia Eagles, Arizona Cardinals, and New England Patriots. The Eagles are plus 450. The Cardinals are plus 600. And the Patriots are plus 750 here for Dalvin Cook's next team. Who should trade for Dalvin Cook? Go down in the comments section. Let me know your thoughts. Who should trade for the Vikings running back? Three words. He's a Dolphin. And I agree with Vegas that I think it's more likely than not that Dalvin Cook is going to be a Miami Dolphin. They apparently reached out to the Vikings about a trade last month. They could not agree on the draft compensation, or at least on the trade compensation, because the Dolphins don't have a whole lot of draft picks. They decided not to trade for Cook. But if Cook gets cut, which looks likely at this point, and Fowler actually said he could be cut before next week's draft, I'd assume the Dolphins are going to be the front runners. And not to mention, Dalvin Cook is from Miami. He might take a pay cut to go back home to the Dolphins. And he was Jalen Ramsey's teammate at Florida State as well. So they might be getting the band back together down there in the 305. Speaking of the Dolphins, Barry Jackson, a Dolphins beat reporter, tweeted this out earlier about the prospect of the Dolphins adding a running back. Dolphins assistant GM Marvin Allen said the team will keep options open with adding a running back in the NFL draft or free agency if the right one arises, possibly the right one being Dalvin Cook. We'll have to see what happens. Tua Tagovailoa also took the podium today and said this about if he contemplated retirement after a couple concussions this year. Yeah, I think I considered it for a time, having sat down with my family and my wife, kind of having those conversations. It would be hard for me to walk away from this game with how old I am. He's just 24 years old. With my son, I always dreamed of playing as long as I could, to the point where my son knew what he's watching. So Tua Tagovailoa admitting that he contemplated retirement after two confirmed concussions this past season, possibly three concussions that he suffered. We never got word on if the Bills game, that first Bills game, if he suffered a concussion that game, but at least two confirmed concussions here for Tua Tagovailoa, both very scary concussions. And if you know, you're an NFL fan, especially Dolphins fan, you're just hoping that Tua Tagovailoa can't stay healthy, because the sky is the limit if he can stay healthy. And may I remind y'all that when the Dolphins were 8-3, they were looking like a Super Bowl contender. Tua was second in MVP odds, only behind Patrick Mahomes. Dolphins going on a losing streak. Tua gets hurt. Obviously, that changes. But the sky is the limit for Tua if he can stay healthy. And to stay healthy, I think the Dolphins have to improve that offensive line. They still have a hole left guard, and especially at right tackle. GM Chris Greer said this morning that they expect Austin Jackson to start at right tackle, which probably does not bode well if you're a Dolphins fan. Hopefully, they can address the right tackle position. Maybe they'll do that in the draft next week. Speaking of the draft, we're starting to see players take their final draft meetings. Today is the last day teams can meet with NFL draft prospects before the big night next Thursday. Here were some notable meetings that took place today. Quarterback C.J. Stroud meeting with the Atlanta Falcons. And the Falcons, you know, they signed Taylor Heinicke to be the backup to Desmond Ridder. They've committed to Desmond Ridder, but still taking the time here to meet with C.J. Stroud about a week before the draft. The Falcons have the number 8 overall pick. The Ravens a little bit further down, but a lot of uncertainty on if Lamar Jackson is going to be back next season. They have been linked to Richardson. They apparently are very high on Anthony Richardson. He met with the Baltimore Ravens today. Meanwhile, Will Anderson Jr. met with the Seattle Seahawks. The Seahawks have the number 5 overall pick. I'd be surprised if he fell number 5. Nolan Smith, we've seen his stock really rise here. Before the combine, he was going to be, what, an early day 2 pick? Now he might be a top 20 pick. He met with the Arizona Cardinals. And then Zay Flowers, the wide receiver from Boston College, he met with the Kansas City Chiefs. Well, I should say at a workout with the Chiefs. Patrick Mahomes wanted to work out with them in Texas. So Zay Flowers in Texas today, working out with maybe his potential future quarterback in Patrick Mahomes. The Chiefs have the number 31 overall selection. It's going to be really interesting to see where Zay Flowers goes.